know that contact lenses are often blamed for causing eye dryness, but is it possible for them to be the cure? In today's video, I'll talk about some ways contacts are used to lessen dry eye symptoms. Welcome back to Eye School with me, Dr. D, where I teach you about products and treatments related to dry eye syndrome and eye beauty so you can have healthy, beautiful, comfortable eyes. Give a little love tap on that subscribe button down below to stay up to date with all the latest eye tips and tricks I have for you. Dryness of the eyes is an extremely common complaint among patients who wear soft contact lenses, and contact lens wear is also a risk factor for dry eye. Like many optometrists, I watch carefully for what TFOS, or the Tear Film and Ocular Surface Society, says about dry eye, and in 2013, they published an entire report on contact lens discomfort, officially linking the two. Dryness in contact lenses is well documented. It can manifest as eyes that feel tired or feeling your lenses throughout the day. And contact lens companies are continually striving to improve their lens designs and materials to reduce dryness as much as possible. But despite contact lenses being the culprit in so many scenarios, it can be hard to believe that they might actually be used to help dry eyes. But that is exactly the case in several different ways. So let's go through some ways doctors use contact lenses to help your dry eyes get better. The first category is protection. Corneal protection is needed in the case of several conditions, including entropion or lids turning in, trichiasis or lashes turning in, certain situations where there might be lid scarring or tarsal scarring, recurrent corneal erosions, post-surgical ptosis, meaning lids that droop down, and surgical sutures or exposed suture knots. The second category is pain relief. The mitigation of corneal pain is another important indication for therapeutic contact lenses. The conditions most in need of this therapy are bullous keratopathy, epithelial erosion, and abrasion. You can also see it in filamentary keratitis and post-operative penetrating keratoplasty, or that is a corneal transplant. And then the third category is for healing. So we can use bandage contact lenses to facilitate healing, and that's particularly necessary in the following conditions. Those are epithelial defects that won't heal, corneal ulcers, neurotrophic keratitis, chemical burns, and even basement membrane disease. So let's go into a little more depth about each of these types of lenses. First, we've got bandage contact lenses. A bandage contact lens is designed to protect an injured, dry, or diseased cornea from the mechanical rubbing of the blinking eyelids. These lenses have no focusing power and are not meant to improve your vision. They are purely to improve pain and allow the eye to heal. As the patient, you're not expected to handle these lenses at all. Bandage contact lenses were studied in their use with autologous serum. One study by Schrader in 2006 tested the use of serum eye drops with a hydrogel bandage contact lens, or a soft lens, for the treatment of persistent epithelial defects, which are spots on the eye that won't heal, dry spots. So one study by Schrader in 2006 tested serum eye drops with hydrogel bandage contact lenses. These are soft lenses, and they tested them for the treatment of persistent epithelial defects. And these are like you might see in several diseases, including dry eye. In this study, the cause of the persistent defect in the cornea ranged from neurotrophic keratopathy to sterile corneal ulcers. So these were pretty sick eyes. But the erosions healed in 5 out of 6 eyes after a treatment period of about 14 days. So in 2 weeks, the use of a soft contact lens along with autologous serum eye drops was able to heal the cornea. There are also several different types of amniotic membranes. Now, some have their own ring, which acts as a scaffolding to hold the membrane in place. I talked about the Procara Slim in this video up above. But another type of amniotic membrane is a dehydrated variety, like the ones I use in my clinic. And for these membranes, you must have a carrier to hold the membrane in place. And for this, we use a bandage contact lens to allow the amniotic membrane to be in contact with the eye and disintegrate over a period of time. Bandage lenses are also used for recurrent corneal erosions. Recurrent erosions are a typical sequela of epithelial basement membrane dystrophy, or they can happen secondary to trauma even many years later. A recurrent corneal erosion will feel like the original injury. It'll feel like you have a scratch on your eye. And we use a bandage contact lens as a second line of treatment after using hyperosmotic drops like Miro 128. We'll use a bandage lens, and they're very, very effective at helping heal the cornea and protect the cornea. We also use bandage lenses with filamentary keratitis. So filamentary keratitis is a condition where strands or filaments composed of degenerated epithelial cells and mucus develop on and adhere to the corneal surface, causing pain and even feeling like something is in your eye. Bandage lenses are extremely helpful in treating this condition as well. Overall, therapeutic bandage lenses promote healing, relieve corneal pain, and protect the ocular surface. It is less of an elective contact lens and more of a medical procedure that is necessary to heal the eye. Okay, if you've made it this far and are still awake, please hit that thumbs up down below so YouTube knows that I'm making quality content. Next, we're going to get into scleral contact lenses. Sclerals are unique contact lenses that work a little differently than traditional soft lenses. These lenses are made of breathable material. Instead of resting on the cornea itself, they rest on the sclera of the eye. This allows for a bowl of saline or artificial tears that becomes trapped in between the lens and the cornea. And in dry eye disease, this ensures constant hydration of the eye while not irritating the cornea like other contact lenses may do. In fact, they protect the cornea from further irritation or damage, and patients can continue to use eye drops and artificial tears during their lens wear, so your daily dry eye routine would not be interrupted. Patients with dry eyes struggle with pain, discomfort, eye exhaustion, confidence issues due to severe eye redness, and more. And scleral lenses do three things at once for these patients. They provide vision correction, they protect the eye, and they serve a therapeutic purpose by lubricating the eye. These factors can improve the quality of life of people with dry eye disease. They decrease pain and discomfort, they decrease eye redness, and the need to repeatedly scratch the eyes or apply eye drops, and they simultaneously provide crisp, clear vision during wear. The next type of contact lens that can actually help your eyes are drug-eluting contact lenses. Research shows drug-laden contact lenses can increase the bioavailability of the drug by up to 50%, which eventually reduces the dose, dosing frequency, systemic drug absorption, and associated side effects of the drug. Drug-eluting contact lenses, which gradually release drugs onto the eye, offer a promising alternative to daily eye drops, which can be unpleasant and hard for patients to properly administer. In a 2016 preclinical study of glaucoma, the engineered lenses lowered eye pressure at least as well as daily eye drops. And recently, Johnson & Johnson launched the Acuvue Theravision with ketotifen for the treatment of allergies. I hope you enjoyed this roundup of different ways that contact lenses can actually help your eyes instead of making your dry eye worse. I hope you enjoyed this video and it helped you see the other side of contact lenses and how doctors are actually using them to help your dry eyes, even if contact lenses were part of the cause of your dry eyes in the first place. And if you've made it this far and you're not already subscribed to my channel, please hit that button and the bell so you don't miss any notifications. That's it for today's Eye School. Class is dismissed.